Hi, welcome to Ramco TV. My name is Brad Vorey and I'm one of the automation specialists at Ramco. Today, we'll be taking a look at the email and texting functions of the Banner DXM. Let's take a look. One of the most powerful features of the DXM is the ability to provide a basic alarm signal when a connected device exceeds a set threshold. For example, if you're monitoring temperature in a cabinet, you can enable a light to turn on or an audible alarm to sound if the temperature exceeds a set value. In some situations, it'd be more beneficial to receive an email or text message when an alarm state occurs. Setting this function up is relatively simple. While you do have the ability to assign the DXM to your existing work email, you may want a separate email account for various reasons, like IT or company restrictions. It's a good idea to always check with your company policies before allowing the DXM to access your company network. If this is the case, the first step is to create a new Gmail account that is dedicated to the DXM. The next step, if you haven't already, is to connect the DXM to your company network. This step might take a little authorization depending on your company restrictions. Work with your IT department on assigning the IP address, but just know that the DXM must have the ability to access an email account. In a lot of cases, you will set up your IP address to dhcp. To set up the network, open your project and go to Settings. Under IP address, select DHCP or enter in your static IP address. Next, under the Mail and Messaging tab, enter in the smtp.gmail.com for SMTP server. For server port, enter in 587. Select situational encryption and check the box for enable SMTP authentication. For username and password, enter in the username and password for the Gmail account you just created. Finally, press the Send SMTP password button. You can send a maximum of 10 different messages from the DXM. Under email recipients, enter in the email address, subject line, and message for what you would like to send when an alarm occurs. In some cases, you may want to send a text message instead of an email. And the good news is that you can do that through the email function. Most cellular companies offer an email to text feature. For example, with Verizon, you would enter in the recipient's phone number, then at vtext.com. Once the alarm is triggered, rather than getting an email, you will get a text. A simple Google inquiry will tell you how to perform an email to text function for your own cellular provider. Under Action Rules, select Add Threshold Rule. Enter in the desired alarm value for your device you are monitoring. Then, under Email, check the box for the message you would like to send that corresponds to one of the 10 messages you created. Finally, download the configuration and the setup for the DXM is complete. Be sure to check your email account. You may have gotten an email indicating that Google blocked someone from signing into your account. From there, back out of your email and go to your Gmail settings under the gear icon. Next, click on Accounts and Import on the top navigation. Then, click on the other Google account settings. Click on Security. Scroll down and under the Less Secure Apps Access, click on Turn On Access. The ability to be immediately notified of a problem is extremely useful, and the DXM from Banner Engineering can easily make this happen. If you're interested in learning more about the DXM, visit ramcoi.com. If you like this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching, and be safe out there.